स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर फाइन एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन इन माई क्लास. एज यू नो दैट आई वॉज टीचिंग चैप्टर डिमांड एंड आई हैव टॉट द मीनिंग ऑफ डिमांड. आई गिवन द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द चैप्टर. आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट डिमांड शेड्यूल, लॉ ऑफ डिमांड. नाउ लेट अस सी डिमांड शेड्यूल. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ डिमांड शेड्यूल. इफ यू सी इंडिविजुअल डिमांड शेड्यूल एंड मार्केट डिमांड शेड्यूल. नाउ आई टोल्ड यू द मीनिंग ऑफ डिमांड. डू यू रिमेंबर द मीनिंग ऑफ डिमांड? If you don't remember, please go through my first video related to demand. There you will get the meaning of demand. Now I like to continue. According to Professor Samuelson, what is demand schedule? Demand schedule shows the relationship between price and quantity demanded. So what is demand schedule? Professor Samuelson has defined. Has given the definition of demand schedule. He stated the relation between the quantity demanded and price is known as demand schedule. Now there are two kinds of demand schedule, individual and market. Individual, when we are talking about individual, that means I am talking about a customer, one consumer. That means when a quantity is demanded by a consumer, a customer at various possible prices at a point of time, it is known as individual demand schedule. What is individual demand schedule? If you remember in my last video, what I did, I showed you demand schedule. Once again, I will be showing you demand schedule. In that demand schedule, I showed you the price that was mentioned in dollars as well as the quantity on different prices, demand quantity demanded at different prices. So what happened in that, you have seen that when price was high, quantity demanded was less, and as price get reduced, quantity demanded was maximum. So if a consumer is demanding at different possible prices, that is individual. And when market, what is market? The definition is same, only one thing changes, that is in that instead of a consumer, several customers are there, several buyers are there. That is the only difference, the slight difference is there only. Otherwise, the definition is same. Let me write the definition. You can note it down, students. Individual demand schedule. Now, what is it? It is a tabular representation. Tabular representation of a consumer, or you can say buyer, is a tabular representation of a means one, a consumer or buyer, did at Now you can see individual demand schedule. It is a tabular representation where you will see a quantity demanded as well as price. So here a consumer is involved. Now if I talk about market demand schedule, whole definition is same, only the word a is omitted. That means there are many consumers, many customers. Okay, so wholesale the definition is all same. Okay, only in market one word is added here. This a is omitted by many consumer and buyers. It can be consumer A, consumer B, consumer C. So hopefully individual demand schedule and market demand schedule is clear to you all. I'm not writing the definition of market demand schedule because it is all same. The only difference is the word a. When I'm saying a, it is one, individual. When I'm saying many, then that means I'm relating to market. And in market, only one consumer is not there. There are many consumers. Now, when we do geometrical representation or graphical representation of this, then it is called individual demand curve. And when we do graphical representation of market demand schedule, then that is called market demand curve. But I am going to show you that also. So students, you can see demand schedule. I have explained you earlier also. Why I am showing you again? Because it is just a representation of a customer, a single. This is individual demand schedule, because here quantity demanded is by only one person. The person's name is not mentioned. Suppose A, B, any person. So this is a quantity demanded by a person, and this represents the demand schedule is representing individual demand schedule. Okay, so hopefully this is clear. You can see the price is mentioned, quantity demanded, and as now it should be clear to you all that when price is maximum, quantity demanded is minimum. When price is least, quantity demanded is maximum. This I've already explained. This is the representation of individual demand schedule. Clear? Okay students, you can see demand curve, the definition is written. The geometrical representation of demand schedule is called demand curve. So the geometrical representation of individual demand schedule is called individual demand curve. Why I'm saying individual? Because in this demand curve, there's a representation of only one customer, only one consumer. It is a representation of individual demand curve only. So this is the example of, or you can say this is just explanation of individual demand curve. Now I will explain you market demand curve. Let us see what is market demand curve. Okay, so student, this is the representation of market demand schedule. Demand schedule, you all know what is this tabular representation of price and quantity demanded. Now it is market demand schedule. So in market demand schedule, I have taken two consumers, A and B. Now this is a price, you can see 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. When price was 5, quantity demanded by consumer A was 1, whereas quantity demanded by consumer B was 2. Likewise, when price was 4, quantity demanded by consumer A was 2, quantity demanded by consumer B was 3. When price was 3, quantity demanded by consumer A was 3, and here for B it was 4. When price was 2, quantity demanded was 4 by consumer A, and quantity demanded by consumer B was 5. And when price was least, that was 1, the price was lowest, so quantity demand was highest by both of them, here 5 and here 6. Now what is market demand? This was individual representation of A and B. Now when we do summation of both the consumer, then we get market demand. So 1 plus 2, 3, 2 plus 3, 5, 3 plus 4, 7, 4 plus 5, 9, 5 plus 6, 11. So this is market demand. So this exactly shows the market demand, or you can say representation of both the consumers, the quantity demanded by both the consumers at various possible prices at a point of time. So this is what called market demand schedule. And when we represent it in a form of graphical or geometrical or in diagrammatic, then it is called market demand curve. Now I'm going to show you you have seen the schedule. Now I'm going to show you the diagram as well. So let us see the diagram now. So students, right now I explained you market demand schedule. Now let's have a look of another market demand schedule on the slide. You can see the image, market demand schedule, price of good X. Suppose any good is there, good X. Its price is given 1, 2, 3, 4. And one thing more, assumption. Assumption means we assume that on what basis this schedule has been drawn. So there are only two consumers or buyers in the market. Why two? See, consumer A, consumer B. We have taken two consumers. Now they have different quantities demanded at different prices. Their quantity demanded will differ. For example, at price 1, quantity demanded by consumer A was 4, consumer B was 5. When price was 2, consumer A demanded 3, consumer B demanded 4 units. When price was 3, consumer A demanded 2 units, whereas consumer B demanded 3 units. And when price was 4, that means was maximum, consumer demanded 1 unit, consumer A demanded 1 unit, whereas consumer B demanded 2 units. Now what is actually market? This was individual. If you see till here, if I remove, so this is individual representation. If I remove this also, I take this and this, again it is individual. But when I am taking into consideration both A and B, and I am doing summation of A and B, then it is market. Now 4 plus 5, 9, 3 plus 4, 7, 2 plus 3, 5, 1 plus 2, 3. So this is representation of market demand. Okay. When we take summation of all the consumers, those who are present in the market, it is called market demand. Now you have seen demand schedule. This is demand curve. Now till now you might have set in your mind that what is actually demand schedule and what is demand curve. I think it is clear to you all. Demand curve is just exactly representation of demand schedule. And what is demand schedule? It is a relation between price and quantity demanded. So demand curve, A is demand curve, you can see. When price was 4, quantity demanded was 1. When price was 3, quantity demanded was 2. When price was 2, quantity demanded was 3. When price was 1, minimum, quantity demanded was maximum 4. B, here when price was 4, he demanded 2 quantity, whereas A demanded 1. So their quantity demanded differs as per their choice. Now here when price was 3, quantity demanded was 3. When price was 2, quantity demanded was 4. When price was 1, quantity demanded was 5. And it is just summation of this. So when price was 4, here you can see quantity demanded, total quantity demanded by both the consumer is 3. Why? Because 1 demanded 1 and 1 demanded 2. So it is just the summation of their demand curves, A's and B's. So this represents market demand curve. Here also the same rule applies. As I said, when price is minimum, quantity demanded is maximum. You can see when price was 1, quantity demanded was 9, that is maximum. When price is high, maximum, quantity demanded is minimum 3. So this was all market demand curve. Now students, note one thing. Market demand is more flatter than individual demand. If you see these two diagrams, you will see that this demand curve is more flatter. Why? There is a reason. Why it is more flatter, can you think? It is more flatter because here proportionate change in quantity demand is more than proportionate change in price. That means price is not changing to that extent as quantity demanded is changing. That is why this curve is more flatter than individual curve. So hope this is clear to you all. If someone asks why the market demand is more flatter, or if this question is asked in your examination, you must write that market demand curve is more flatter than individual demand curve. It is because the proportionate change in quantity demanded is more, because your summation of 2 is considered, whereas proportionate change in price is not that. That is why it is more flatter. So hopefully student, it is clear. Okay students, one more topic. We were discussing about demand curve. So let us discuss the slope of demand curve. You have seen the slope of demand curve. It is downward sloping. If you see, the slope of demand curve is downward sloping, and it is from leftward to rightward. Okay, now what is the slope of demand curve? The slope of demand curve represents delta P by delta Q. What is delta P? Delta P is proportionate change in price to a proportionate change in quantity demanded. Price is represented on y-axis, whereas quantity demanded is represented on x-axis. Now what is delta P? Suppose this is price. Price 5. At price 5, quantity demanded is suppose 4. Okay, now when there is a change in price, either price rises or either price fluctuates or gets decreased. And if there is any change in quantity demanded, that particular change, delta P, is represented as change in price, and delta Q is represented as change in quantity demanded. If from 4 we shift to 5, so this 4 to 5, there will be a change of what? 1 unit, so that will be delta 1. And here from 3 to 5, so 3 to 5, how much change is there? 2. So here will be 2. So now one thing more, when we represent it, we put minus sign. Why minus sign? Because it shows an inverse relation between price and quantity demanded. What is inverse relation? Inverse relation means when price is high, quantity demanded is less. And when price is more, quantity demanded is less. When price is high, basically quantity demanded is less. And when price is less, quantity demanded is more or high, you can say. So this minus sign indicates the inverse relationship. So slope of demand curve, if it is asked or anyone asks you, make it sure slope of demand curve is equal to delta P upon delta Q, which is proportionate change in price to a proportionate change in quantity demanded. Thank you students. I am ending here. We will be meeting soon in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.